Bruce, these last few weeks, I worry about the toll they've taken on you. Facing off against Harvey and Oswald in a matter of days. Not just the physical toll. Those were men you once trusted, and after finding out what you did about your father, people must seem a great disappointment to you. Always letting you down, even those whom you admire.
Not everyone is like my father or Oswald. And what Harvey became, it wasn't by choice.
And me? Everything that happened, I could have stopped it if I'd done something all those years ago. This is my fault. All of it. I told you I wanted to leave your father's employ. But if only I had the guts to do something instead. Your mother, she wanted that. Wanted to put an end to his crimes. If I'd helped her... If I'd stopped Thomas, none of these horrors would have occurred.
I don't blame you for what happened, Alfred. You did the best you could in an impossible situation. And it helped to make me the man I am today.
I... Thank you, Bruce.
But our work isn't done. The children of Arkham are still out there. And Lady Arkham.
With both Penguin and Mayor Dent off the board, she's the only remaining piece.
We need to figure out her next move. The only thing we do know is that she moved on from her plan to poison the city. With Penguin gone and my CEO access restored, I can finally log into Wayne Enterprises and see exactly what Oswald was doing during his time in charge. If I cross-reference that with all the data we have on Vicky Vale, we might be able to figure out the Children of Arkham's next move. Vicky Vale, mid-30s, reporter for the Gotham Gazette, and not in the public record, her true name, Victoria Arkham.
To think she was here, in the manor. She gave nothing away of her true nature then.
Vicky embraced this identity to follow through on her twisted crusade.
Her mask inspires fear. Not unlike Batman.
I just need to find her. Children of Arkham. Their symbol dates back much farther than their terrorist activity. They formed to get justice for those wronged at Arkham Asylum. But the message fell on deaf ears. Until they found a leader Gotham couldn't ignore.
The Gazette's records of the articles written by Vicky Vale.
This record isn't complete.
You're right. There are notable gaps between entries. But yet, it doesn't seem she ever left the Gazette's employ. So what was she doing in that time?
This record wouldn't be easy to alter. Seeing what Oswald was up to could give us a fresh perspective.
Your administrative access to Wayne Enterprises should have been reinstated by now, along with your title of CEO.
Let's see what Oswald was doing while he sat in my chair.
Master Cobblepot's sense of humor hasn't changed much since you were boys.
Can we just see what he was doing?
Penguin was tapping into surveillance systems across Gotham. Any building using Wayne Tech security could be spied on from the CEO's office.
How is that any different than the back door into the Wayne network that he uncovered?
That's not... Unless... Hold on. Oswald was trying to buy an island.
What on earth for?
Looks like he was using his new legal control of Carmine Falcone's assets and likeness to brand the place. It's some kind of tourist attraction.
He was going to call it
Falcone Island. We need to figure out Lady Arkham's next move.
Of course.
Oh, Oswald certainly wasn't very frugal with my money.
You have a few yachts to return, it appears.
Also explains how the Children of Arkham had a seemingly endless supply of guns. Oswald was using Wayne money to arm them. Oswald altered several public records using the Wayne network. Oswald manipulated my records as well.
It would appear your degree was in sociology.
And my medical records.
There are some, well, but colorful diseases.
Annoying, but not hard to fix.
That's better.
Well, no surprise here. Oswald wiped away any trace of his criminal records. His background is completely fabricated.
He was enrolled at Cambridge? Ridiculous.
Calm down, Alfred. I'm sure the board realizes by now that they were fooled.
All mention of her birth name, Victoria Arkham, is completely gone.
Wait. What's this?
He also erased something from Vicky's research at the Gazette. I can't tell what was removed from here, but Wayne Tech leaves a trace when it alters data. One the Bat Computer can decode.
What is it Miss Vale wanted to hide?
What do we have here? They did more than just look at these schematics. Every building in Gotham with a Wayne Tech security system can be accessed from here and remotely controlled. If Oswald was the brawn, Vicky is the brains. So let's check her file. She may have left clues about what she was using Oswald's access for.
Now that we know how Oswald manipulated Vicky's records, the Bat Computer should be able to... There. No more holes.
She was looking into Arkham patients. Reviewing records, checking submissions, prior histories. She was trying to figure out who was actually sick and who was committed because of Hill, Falcone... and my father.
Vicky was digging deep. Gotham City records, freedom of information requests, posts to conspiracy forums. All to find...
It's a list. Gotham buildings that use Wayne Tech security systems.
It's a list of targets.
City Hall, Arkham Asylum, GCPD headquarters, Gotham First National. It's almost every landmark in the city.
We're onto something.
Vicky wants to bypass the security at a Gotham landmark. But without a man inside Wayne Enterprises, she can't unlock that door remotely. She'll have to get her hands dirty.
And when she does, we'll find her. Speaking of...
Is it Lady Arkham?
No, it's one of Lucius's prototypes. On the move.
What? But Lucius locked everything away.
Well, he needed a better lock.
She stole from you? After we opened our doors to her? After all that you two...
Alfred.
Yeah, I know, Bruce, but... Why would she do this? Is she that cold-hearted? That selfish?
She must have her reasons.
Well, I'm sure she does.
Computer visual.
The prototype she stole. It's an electronic skeleton key.
With it, you could bypass any security system made by Wayne Tech.
That key is far too dangerous in Ms. Kyle's hands, especially with Lady Arkham still at large.
Get the car ready, Alfred.
And Alfred, let Lucius know what's happened.
I'm going to get some answers from Selina.
I wasn't expecting you. Thought I'd make it outside the city limits, at least. Clearly my ride needs a tune-up.
If you wanted to see me, you could have just called.
The chase is so much more fun. But I know you're not here for me. Are you? I don't blame you for wanting it back. I'm surprised you had a toy like this. No doubt Batman would use it for the good of Gotham, but the less noble options are so much more exciting. Why should I give it back? So much potential. Just imagine what I'd be able to dig my claws into.
A thief of your class doesn't need a device like that. It'd only be a crutch.
Says the man whose belt is an armory. Catch. I know you're just playing into my pride, but you're right. I don't need a crutch. Oh, come on. Don't pretend you're not impressed. As long cons go, this one was a beauty. Getting into Wayne Tech's lab took a lot more than cracking a safe. I had to get close to people. Your friend Harvey. Poor guy just wanted to fall in love so bad. After that, it didn't take very long to get my introduction to his BFF. The great Bruce Wayne. Imagine my surprise when the rich playboy turned out to be Batman, scourge of Gotham.
You talk a good game, but I don't buy it for a second. You're not that shallow.
You really think you know me that well?
I know that whatever this started as... That's not all it means to you now.
The only thing it means is that I'm very good at my job. I'm getting out of here while the getting's good. Gotham's a house on fire, and I'm not gonna burn with it. If you were smart, you'd get out of here too. This town hates you, hates your entire family. Just leave it all behind. Do something more meaningful. With those skills of yours. You don't need the money, but... But think of the fun.
Gotham needs me. And I won't abandon the people of this city, no matter how they feel about me.
After the way they've treated you, you've got one hell of a thick skin. You're gonna need it. It'll be good to put some distance between us. After all, look at what happened to Harvey. It'd only be a matter of time before I crossed one of your lines. Isn't that right? My copy of the Boy Scout Handbook is out of date. I'm bound to break some rule.
Harvey was out of control, and he wanted to destroy Gotham. If you did the same, and yes, I'd put you behind bars in a heartbeat.
Looks like we're back where we started when we first met on that rooftop. Enemies.
That's not what I want, Selina. I don't want to be enemies.
Look, Bruce, I'll admit that what you and I had, it wasn't terrible. But you were just another job. A more intriguing job than I was expecting. But still a job. And that job's done. I'm done with you. It's not complicated. I'm not a good person. I'm certainly no hero, and I don't want to be. I'm a thief. That's all I am. I told you that from the start. I never pretended to be anything else.
Stop. That's not true. I know there's more to you than that. You're just afraid to admit it.
You'd like it if that were true, wouldn't you? Why would you even think that? I've made my feelings pretty clear. Why aren't you listening?
You fought by my side. And together we saved a lot of lives. We're a good team, Selena.
You had to know that wouldn't last. But it was nice. While it did. You know, after I found out you were Batman, I thought nothing else could surprise me. But you just keep on surprising me. Anyway. Well, it's been fun.
Stay out of trouble. If I catch you taking what's not yours again, I'll have to stop you.
I look forward to our next dance.
Lucius, I've got the key. Hold on, Alfred's on the line. Hey, Alfred, I...
Bruce! Lady Arkham! She's here! I tried to keep them out, but...
Alfred? Alfred! Alfred!
Lucius, it's Bruce. He's not here. Damn it.
I'm going to search for clues.
Just tell me how I can help.
Get over here as fast as you can.
I'm on my way. We're gonna find him, Bruce.
I know. Need to focus. Figure out what happened here.
What happened to you, Al? What did they do to you, Alfred? Ash everywhere.
A scuff mark.
What could have caused this? Furniture scattered outwards from a single point. Something big was thrown against this wall. Or someone.
Face was knocked over in the struggle. The fight left nothing untouched. Blood pattern looks like it came off a high-velocity hit.
This pool cue was used as a weapon, swung so hard it broke in half.
Alfred used the pool cue as a weapon, broke it across his attacker's head. When that didn't stop him, he used the jagged end to stab him, spraying blood across the pool table.
The lock's been completely destroyed. Alfred must have barricaded himself in here. But they got in anyway. How the hell...
Alfred grabbed the fireplace poker to fend off an attacker. But it was knocked away.
Lady Arkham must have used the concussion blast from her staff to try and stop Alfred. I know what happened. The children of Arkham broke in. Alfred barricaded himself inside the parlor. He had just enough time to grab a pool cue as a weapon before Lady Arkham blasted the doors open. He broke it across one of their heads, then stabbed him to get away. Another assailant tackled Alfred, knocking over the vase. Alfred almost escaped, but then Lady Arkham entered the parlor. Used her staff's concussion blast, scattering all the furniture in her path, throwing him against the wall by the fireplace. So Alfred grabs the nearest thing to use as a weapon to defend himself. But Lady Arkham deflected Alfred's attack, causing the poker to fly across the room and lodge into the wall. More blood on the mantle. He smashed his face into it. Wait. That picture doesn't belong there. Lady Arkham wanted me to find this. No idea. Keep a cool head, Lucius. Worrying isn't going to help Alfred. We need to focus.
You're right. Let's get started.
Alfred keeps adjusting his glasses. The reflection. He's making sure I see the reflection in his glasses. He knows the Bat Computer can use multiple reflection angles to recreate the room that he's in. And I can view the virtual image using my cowl.
Good thinking, Alfred.
Okay, Lucius. Freeze frame on the first signal Alfred gives.
Paint us a picture. Here we go.
He's wounded.
Must be one of the thugs Alfred fought upstairs.
Stairs leading up, cement walls. We're in a basement. Alfred's trying to look at things that might give us a clue to where he's being held. Professional grade camera. Probably came from the Gazette's office.
Okay, looks like we've seen all there is to see in this frame. Let's move on to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
Rogers Plumbing. A service company for the water heater. I can use their records to find home addresses for their clients.
We're getting closer.
Yeah, but we're not there yet. Doesn't seem to be anything else here.
Let's keep looking.
Nothing else to see here.
Moving on.
Stamp.
Only one Masonic lodge in the city. Gotham City Fraternal Order of Stonemasons.
So the house was built in 1945 by them. That's a big lead. Lady Arkham. Keep searching. Jump to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
Basement window.
What's that outside?
Give me a second. They're by a bus stop.
Here we go.
Okay, I think we have enough to pinpoint a location.
Well, let's hope.
Filtering for all homes built on that date. These are all the homes serviced by this water heater company on the days and months listed. I can get the bus line from this, but no stop number. This will help pinpoint the neighborhood. Bowling alley. Damn it. Let's keep looking. A corner store? Seems unlikely. You are not going to believe this.
What is it?
Lady Arkham is back at the Vale House, where she killed her foster parents. According to its records, it has a basement.
Well, just in case she's expecting you?
What is that?
Something I almost didn't get to finish because of Penguin. It's the most advanced version yet.
Lady Arkham will have no idea what I've got up these sleeves. Well done, Lucius.
You've been long overdue for an upgrade. This suit is beyond state of the art. This ends tonight. Heading into the basement.
Be careful.
I'm all right. There's no one here. No Alfred.
Damn it!
There's blood on the walls. I'm going to see what I can find.
Standing by.
Alfred's blood is still fresh.
Means we can't be far behind them.
This is where they had Alfred. Where they beat him.
Alfred. There's a boot print in the blood. Lady Arkham's soldiers dragged him. The trail stops at the wall. Actually, it goes under it.
Sounds like there's more to this basement than it would appear.
Taking a closer look. The wall is just a facade.
Why would the Vales have a false wall in their basement?
Now let's find out what the Vales were hiding. There's a small room. With a hole in the floor. Ladder.
Anyone down there would be trapped.
I'm going inside. Children may not have been the only ones to suffer here. I followed Alfred's blood into this hole. If he had any opportunity at all, he would have left me a clue. The belt. It's caked in blood. Shackles. Blood on them. Old and new. Vicky did to Alfred what was done to her. Alfred laid down here. Disturbing. Vicky created her here, in this room. This is where Vicky Vale became Lady Arkham. There are drawings. Vicky must have drawn them when she was a prisoner. The chalk here is different, newer. One piece apart from the others. Yellow. The same color as my tack. Can't be a coincidence. Maybe... an arrow. Pointing to a building. Arkham. Alfred has highlighted three words. Shall be unleashed. Alfred left me another clue. This is what he wanted me to find. To see. Alfred is highlighted. Shall be unleashed. And he's pointing me to her drawing of Arkham.
Sounds like something out of a fire and brimstone sermon.
That's exactly what it is. Alfred's just along for the ride. She's been using Wayne Enterprises to get access to the buildings with Wayne Tech security systems, including Arkham Asylum. She's going to open the doors, release the inmates, and she took Alfred with her. Call Gordon in the GCPD.
I'm on it.
Lady Arkham won't be expecting us. We'll catch her by surprise.
Orderlies are rounded up.
That's the last of it, then.
The children of Arkham have taken over.
That suits no slouch. You're well prepared for a fight. And the GCPD are on their way to deal with the inmates. If you can find Alfred, maybe you can get him out of there before all hell breaks loose.
Almost ready. Let her know.
Copy. On our way. Go ahead. I got this.
Batman!
This ends now, Vicky. Tell me where Alfred Pennyworth is.
The butler. Bruce Wayne has a bat on his payroll.
Answer the question.
Where he is doesn't matter. He'll be dead soon. Another corpse in Bruce Wayne's family.
Killing him won't solve anything.
But it will teach Bruce Wayne a lesson. One he and all of Gotham will learn. They won't look the other way. Not again.
And when did Gotham look away from you, Vicky?
Don't try to psychoanalyze me, Batman. You have no idea what I've done to come this far. Too much to turn back now.
I know you suffered. You were tortured, held captive by the people who were supposed to love you. I don't know how you survived.
You want to know how I survived? I survived because every night I dreamed of the revenge I'd take on them. And this forsaken city. Your time's run out. Underestimate the true children of Arkham. These souls kept behind bars. Open the doors! Arkham! Listen to me! Freedom is yours! The only one standing in your way is Batman.
Batman.
He stuck me in here!
Me too. Let me out.
He's the crazy one.
Security systems offline. Every inmate's loose.
The leader of the Children of Arkham, did you see her?
They went.
Vicky.
Such a pleasure to see your work in person.
Batman!
Lady Arkham has a hostage.
We've got the inmates. Lock it down!